genocide in Rwanda, the 20th anniversary of which we mark this week, provided Americans with one of our most painful examples of a failure to act. But not Americans alone, Mr. Speaker. The entire civilized world.
We are here today because we do remember the victims of the horrific events in our world's history. And we honor survivors and recognize the steps that have been taken to remedy the atrocities that have occurred.
It's not anything that I can imagine. The wholesale use of murder in ethnic cleansing in order to achieve a political goal.
Murdered. Murdered not because of their engagement in war, not because of their engagement in crime, but because of who they were, what religion they had, what ethnic background they claimed.
And all of us must take some of the responsibility and share in the blame.
We're the only country that has the ability to see that mankind doesn't engage in horrific genocides again. So when the opportunity for the United States to get involved and save a slaughter, save a genocide, the United States has responsibility.
And as much as some of us abhor war, and as much as we know that it's not the best utilization to get involved in warlike activity that's unnecessary, I think that there are some things that you just can't let go.
And so we must continue to fight for justice as the international issues come to our consciousness. And we know that as time moves on, there will be additional tragedies around the globe.
That when we see evil, we won't stand silently by. We will stand against it and fight.
I beg the International Criminal Tribunal for Rwanda to continue their quest for justice and to bring those to trial, those who have up to now escaped the might of justice.
Dr. King once said, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. And so it is, evil anywhere is a threat to all of us everywhere.
I hope Americans across the country will take some time this week to reflect not only on the Rwandan genocide, but all genocides. To remember its horrors and to promise never to let our nation sit idly by as a genocide takes place.